The incidence of dengue has increased in the region of the Americas over the past four decades, from 1.5 million cumulative cases in the 1980s to 16.2 million cases between 2010 and 2019. In the region, the French Caribbean islands are currently experiencing dengue outbreaks, with a total of over 17,000 cases reported cumulatively. In August of 2020, the Ministry of Health and Wellness of St. Lucia declared an outbreak of dengue fever. To date, St. Lucia has recorded a total of 503 confirmed dengue cases. Although cases have been identified throughout the island, most of the confirmed cases are concentrated in the northern region in areas such as Castries, Bexar, and Central Babono. 53% of the cases are male, indicating a slightly higher occurrence in the male sex. The age group 5 to 14 years accounts for approximately 39% of cases, of which 57% are male. A total of 128 confirmed dengue cases have been hospitalized. 56% of these hospitalized cases are male, of which the less than 14-year age group is most affected. In St. Lucia, all four serotypes of dengue have been known to circulate, and for 2020, most serotypes 2 and 3 have been identified in the population, accounting for 14% and 3% of the cases respectively. Dengue fever is a mosquito-borne disease transmitted by the bite of the Aedes aegypti mosquito. Persons infected with the virus develop signs and symptoms on average 5 days after being bitten by the mosquito. The most common symptoms of dengue fever include fever, headache, pain behind the eyes, muscle and joint pain, and a red itchy rash. Characteristic in children is the appearance of glands to the neck. Symptoms generally last for 5 days, with resolution of the fever at day 5. There may be persistence of the fever beyond day 5 with worsening of one's general condition. This occurs in approximately 5% of persons who progress to the more severe form of dengue infection. In its more severe form, persons may experience bleeding from the gums or nose, vomiting blood or passing blood in the stool, and or severe abdominal pain. There is no vaccine or specific treatment for dengue. Management is strictly supportive based on presenting symptoms. The simultaneous infection of individuals in the same household has been noted in this outbreak of dengue fever. It is important to note that dengue fever cannot be transmitted from one person to another in the absence of the Aedes aegypti mosquito. An infected individual and the mosquito are both required for the transmission of dengue fever. Prevention and control therefore involves the elimination of the Aedes aegypti mosquito. The Ministry of Health and Wellness has been engaging in activities aimed at the reduction and control of the spread of dengue fever. Such activities include increased public education, cleanup campaigns, island-wide fogging, and the inspection of premises with complaints. The public is reminded of the measures to reduce the mosquito population, such as removal of all open containers with stagnant water in and surrounding your home on a regular basis, such as flower plates, pots, and used tires. If that is not possible, water containers can be treated with larvicides. Tight control of water containers, barrels, wells, and other storage tanks. Use of window or door screens by the population wherever possible. There are also measures which can be adopted to prevent the bite. These include the use of repellents and wearing of long sleeve shirts and long pants, especially during the hours of highest mosquito activity. Use of long-lasting insecticidal treated mosquito bed nets. Together, we can work to improve the dengue situation in St. Lucia. The Ministry of Health and Wellness will continue to provide the public with updates on the dengue situation in St. Lucia.